Fourth, Al-Malik. Al-Malik. The one who possesses the attribute of Mulk, incomparable greatness and majesty, subduing and administering. He opposes the absolute, or he rather possesses the absolute disposal of the affairs, creating, commanding, and recompensing. To him belongs the entire world, the lofty and low spheres. They depend upon him, and they are his slaves. His command is executed in his kingdom. None can repulse his command. There is none above him, and everything is but below Allah. All of this explains the meaning of Al-Malik, the name Al-Malik, the one who possesses the attribute of Mulk. The fifth name, Al-Malik. Al-Malik. The name Al-Malik is more comprehensive than the name Al-Malik. And Allah the Most High is Malik, who perfectly possesses all the possessors. He is the one who enables the possessors to dispose the affairs in their possessions. Allah is the Malik, the one who possesses the Mulk, the kingdom. He gives the kingdom to whom he wills, and he takes it from whom he wills. He endues with honor whom he wills, and he humiliates whom he wills. In his hand is the good, and he is able to do all things. Allah is the Malik, the only owner, and the only ruling judge of the day of recompense. That is the day of resurrection, the most great. The sixth name, Al-Malik, the omnipotent king, the all-blessed, the most high, the owner of majesty and honor. From a lexicology, Al-Malik and Al-Malik and the Malik refer to, quote, the one who possesses, end of quote.